the session, and we saw how to control a robot through internet. We also saw some virtual robots like robotic arm being controlled on your desktop. And here you saw Pandit 2.0, which was controlled through internet, and many 2 to 3 participants got an opportunity to control it. And today's session, we will be talking about augmented reality in robotics. So augmented reality in robotics and ball tracking using computer vision. So these are the two things we will be talking today. So my name is V.S. Rajashekar, and I'm a project assistant at Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. My areas of interest include mobile robots, bio-inspired robots, computer-aided multi-body dynamics, manipulators, aerial grasping, computer-controlled robots, mechanism design, and compliant robots. So today we will be seeing about computer-controlled robots, so which can be connected, if the computer is connected to the internet, it can be connected to the computer. So what I mean is, if a robot is being controlled through a computer, then it can be controlled from any part of the world. So the topics covered in today's session include the following. So the software used to create and understand robotics, augmented reality. This is a hands-on session. Augmented reality, controlling a robotic arm, and computer vision, tracking a ball's trajectory. So we will be covering these things. In softwares, we will be talking about FreeCAD, which is used to create CAD models. And then we'll be talking about MechAnalyzer, which will be used to teach mechanisms for students. And we'll also be seeing about RoboAnalyzer, which will be used to teach robotics and find out the workspace, understand the DH parameters in it. So all the softwares which I'm going to teach today are all open source or freely available for academic use. So you can feel free to download them and then you can use it in your computer. Now I'll show you some of the computer controlled robots that I have made. So this is an alphabet writing robot, that is a letter writing robot which writes the alphabet A, B, C, D, and so on up to Z. So if I press the A button on the screen, it starts writing the alphabet A. This was created using Processing IDE, which was taught to you yesterday and will be taught to you today also. So this is the alphabet A. Now it's going to write the letter B. So if the button B is pressed, it will write the letter B. So this is a simple 2R robot, that is 2 revolute joint robot. It has 2 revolute joints and 2 links. On both the revolute joints are activated. This is done using servo motors. 2 servo motors are being used here. So the letter C is going to be written once it is clicked. The letter C is clicked and the robot starts writing the letter C. So next is a foldable staircase mechanism which I made. So this foldable staircase mechanism can be controlled from a computer. So this can be used in places where there are cramped. So this is a model where if there is no power, this model of staircase will work. So if there's no power, you can take it up like this using a hoist. So this is a gyro sensor which is being this is a gyro sensor which is being used. So the gyroscope is being used to find the orientation of the object. So you can see the gyroscopic sensor over here and the Arduino board on the top. So this is the gyroscopic sensor which measures the angle, and you can control an object on the screen by using this. So coming to the software for learning robotics, the first software which we will be seeing is Mechanalyzer. It is a completely open source software and it is available completely free for academic use. So about Mechanalyzer, it is a 3D model based software developed for effective teaching and learning of mechanism related courses. This can be used by professors in universities to teach students how mechanisms are developed for creating robots. So robot, backbone of any robot is a mechanism, a four bar mechanism or something like that. So this is developed by the Department of Mechanical Engineering at IIT Delhi under the guidance of Professor S.K. Saha. It is freely available for academic use. So coming to the software, we will see the overview of this software. I'll be sending the links in the chat box soon. So you can select a mechanism over at the bottom, that is a slider crank mechanism or a four bar mechanism. Then you can change the link length. The link lengths are being changed over here. And the link lengths are being, a link AC is being added. And then it is animation is played, like the simulation is done. And then you can, while the simulation is going on, you can try to increase the link lengths so that it can change. So the notations can also be seen, like what link is what in the feature. So the graph for the position, velocity, and acceleration can be plotted. And you can visualize how the mechanism behaves. So coming to the next software called RoboAnalyzer, this is a quite famous software in India. I'm sure some of you would be aware of it. So this software is an open source software, like open source in the sense it's freely available for academic use. And you can use this software for teaching and learning robotics concepts. So it is an evolving product. It is developed at a mechatronics lab of Department of Mechanical Engineering at IIT Delhi. And it is also developed under the guidance of Professor S.K. Saha. So you can see the robo analyzer software being used here. So you can choose the number of degrees of freedom of the robo and select the robo. So these are the DH parameters, Dennewitt-Hartenberg parameters. The link lengths can be chosen. So the frame transformations can be seen now. That is the coordinate frame. So this is how the transformation happens. The transformation matrices can be seen by clicking the link config and then updating the link. These are very important concepts in making a robotic arm. So the initial and final values for the joints are being set. And then the number of steps is decided. And forward kinematics is done. Then the simulation starts. So what it is drawing in black color circles is the workspace of the robot. Okay. So this robot analysis software can be actually downloaded for free, and you can give a feedback to the user, to the creators, by clicking the feedback link which is on the top. So coming to FreeCAD, FreeCAD is a open source software, and it can be used for creating models of robots. And before going to the FreeCAD demo, if anyone has FreeCAD software installed on a laptop, they can open it. Otherwise, they can just view it over here. Okay, so this is the FreeCAD software. If you open the software, it will be like this. You have to click on new, a new thing. And then there are a lot of options here. A2 plus is for assembly. AARC is for architecture. Assembly 2, assembly 2, 4 are for assemblies. And drafting, FEM, finite element method, and inspection can be done. And part design, parts can be made over here. So what I'm trying to show is something called as a robo, which is available over here. And we'll click on the robo called as KUKA IR500. And we have to click on this icon. So this robo CAD model can be seen. So if you click on the robo, you get the task robot six axis thing, a dialog box, and you can just try to move the robo so that it moves. So this is the first axis, that is base. This is the shoulder. This is the arm. These are the wrist joints. So this is the last axis, which is moving over here. That may not be visible to you, but other axes can be seen. Okay, so coming to the next thing, so you can create CAD models by clicking on part design, and you can actually click on the drawing, select the plane and click OK, and then maybe draw a cylinder. We'll try to draw a cylinder. So this, and we'll try to extrude it. So we can change the values of the length of the cylinder, and that will be created. And if you want to assign color, you can go to appearance, shape color, say you want to apply orange. Okay, close. Okay. So the you can create a cylinder like called, which is orange in color. So I hope this is the short demo about FreeCAD software. Next, we will be moving to augmented reality. So augmented reality is something where you can use your mobile phone or any camera device which is connected to the computer or the internet, and you can actually see the warehouse in this picture. So what happens is it looks at the stock, and it says how much task is remaining, 5 items is remaining, and so on, by just looking at the images seen in the camera. So it will say, we are going to do something similar to that. So these are the links for the FreeCAD and Robo Analyzer. I'll post it in the chat. So I hope everyone has got the message in the chat. So this two web softwares, you can use it, not in this session, but sometime when you're free. So which software is used to best to develop robots? There's nothing called as best software in the world. There are something called as open source software and paid software. In open source software, you can use FreeCAD to make robots, or you can use Blender to make robots. I hope I have answered your question. So if you have any doubts so far, you can ask, unmute yourself and ask. So can we move on to the hands-on session?
Participants, it is unmuted. If you wish to interact with the resource person, you can interact. Provision for audio is enabled. Earlier, so many of you opened the audio note and you were in the conversation. That's why muted. Now it is again unmuted. Any one of you can communicate. If you wish, you can interact. Yes, sir, there is no response. We can proceed, sir.
Okay, fine. So can we move on to the hands-on session? I hope you have the processing software which we used yesterday. Can you open the software? I'll wait for a minute. And you have the files also. If you don't have the files, then I'll send the link again in the chat box. This is the file. If you have downloaded it yesterday, then it is okay. And if you don't have it, you can download it now. If you have any doubts, you can ask, post your questions in the chat box. I'll be happy to answer. So has everyone opened the processing software? So if you please communicate, like please respond. Participants, okay, fine. So what we will do now is we'll open, go to sketch, import library and add library. I repeat, sketch, import library, add library. We are using processing for this session. So if you have opened this, please navigate down and look at this NYAR4PSG. So click on that and press install. NYAR4PSG, that is NYAR toolkit for processing. I will repeat the steps again. Go to Sketch, Import Library, Add Library, and navigate down, and you can find NYAR4PSG. And click on Install. So, has it been installed, participants? Okay. I hope for some of them it would have been installed by now. I'll move on. You can go to File, Open. Go to your desktop and you would have extracted IoT_robotics. And please go inside that and click on AR_controlled_robo. And click on AR_controlled_robo.pde. So the inside the folder called AR_controlled_robo, so there is a folder called data. In that there is something called as pat.hiro, PATT.HIRO. So you can open it with your text editor. And this thing contains the data about the hero marker. So the hero marker which I sent you in the group, I hope some of you would have taken printout of it. So that will be used in this particular session. So what you have to do is you have to go back to the sketch, and then you have to run it. We'll see the output first, and then we will look into the other thing. So what happens here is, I'm going to show something called as hero. So if I show the object something called as hero, so a robo appears on the screen. Or we'll change the dimensions of the screen so that it can be a little bigger. I have kept it as 1000 so that it will be a little wider. So we'll keep this as normal because the image is getting stretched, it is not able to detect it. So wherever you see the robo, the hero marker will be present behind it. Like wherever the hero marker is there, the robo will appear in front of it. So now you can control the, this is what is augmented reality. So you can control the augmented robo. So the base, shoulder and arm can be controlled. So now what I'll do is I'll try to rotate this hero marker. The robo also rotates. Now if you want to see the robo upside down, you can see it upside down by just rotating the hero marker. And on the again on the side. And again back to original position. So this will be an interesting project for students in computer science, especially because they are creating something on virtually, and it is being seen, able to see, being seen by them through some source like a hero marker.
So data file name.
Can you come again, sir?
Data file name.
File name is, you have to go to file, open, okay. And then go to your desktop and IoT and AR underscore control robot.
Okay, that is fine, sir. For data, for data.
For data in the sense, I'm not able to.
Opening it in editor, which you did it. Text editor, like going to the folder robotic arm data folder, there which file we should open?
Not inside data, it is outside data behind. Like AR underscore control robot dot PDE.
Okay. Robotic arm we have, that is
no, not robotic arm, that is different, that is yesterday's thing. So this AR underscore controlled underscore robo.
Okay.
So inside that AR controlled robo, like AR underscore controlled underscore robo.
Okay.
.pde is an extension file for processing software. Like whatever you have to open in processing, so those have an extension called PDE or processing development environment. So have you got the output? Can participants, you can unmute yourself and reply. I'm waiting for your reply, participants. Execution step in the sense like how to run the simulation, like you just need to press on the run once the screen is open. And then show the hero marker which you have with you, which you have taken printout of it. So if you have any doubts, you can post it in the chat or you can unmute yourself and ask.
Sir, they are asking for execution steps, sir.
Yeah, I showed them again actually.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, I want to make the session more interactive, so I'll be giving a small task. Okay, so if anyone has got the output, please send an email to me, the screenshot of it. So the first two participants who send it will be getting a gift, that is a book on robotics. Let's see who does it first. Okay, fine. I'll just go ahead and explain the code. And if anyone has done it, please send it to this email ID, vsrajshekhar@gmail.com. I would be happy to give you a gift as a robot book related to robotics. So this is the program is going to be explained now. So import processing.video. So the processing software is going to import something called video. So the processing video, that is where, which is being used to display the video at the back, as you saw now. Then import this library. So this library is because we are using this augmented reality. So this jp.nyatala.nyar4.psg. This is used because we are using augmented reality. So next is control P5. Control P5 is being used to control the augmented robo. And this P shape is being used to import the models into that model, into the screen. So that is base, body, shoulder cylinder, and arm. So these four are being imported. And then control P5. Control P5 is being declared, and capture. What we are going to capture is a video that is stored as cam in the variable cam. So the multi marker is named as NYA, that is the hero marker. So next we are declaring some initializing some variables called as LF, string, base, shoulder, arm. So initially they are all set to 000. And void setup, the size is of the screen is being set up. That is 640 x 480. So please try to maintain this ratio, because only if it is a square, we will be able to get the expected output. And P3D, this is where this is used to import something in 3D. That is the whatever you see on the screen is not in plane. It is in 3D. That is why we are using 3D. Otherwise, you can use 2D and you can create robots which are two dimensional in nature. Next, the color mode is set to RGB. Then the multi-marker version is being printed. Then the smooth is given to make a smooth transition, and the frame rate is set to 30. Then the body is loaded, that is body.object, the base.object is loaded, the shoulder cylinder is loaded, and the arm is also loaded. Then there are quite a few lines which take care of importing the camera input, and then giving comparing it with the pat.hero in the data file, I showed you earlier. And then what happens is we are setting up the controls, that is the sliders called as base, shoulder, arm. The three sliders are being set up. And then this void setup is getting over here. Whatever is we saw till now will get executed only once. Then void draw. What happens here in the background is detected, and then the camera reads the values and it compares it with the existing marker. And if it is not, then it will return back. Then if it finds it in relation with the existing marker which I showed, that is the hero marker, then it will scale the model by 50%, and then it will start going into the draw base fixed function. So the draw base fixed function is over here. So what happens in draw base fixed, we call the another function called as draw link base. And like yesterday, we are calling the base, body, shoulder, and arm. So this is the explanation for the program. If you have any doubts, I'll give the next 5 minutes to the audience. You can ask it. Please utilize this. No, it is not in Python actually, it is in JavaScript. So I'll show something interesting. There is something called as Android mode also in this processing software. And if you want to convert this code into a mobile app, you can just click on Android. And then connect your mobile, Android mobile to the computer and enable the debugging mode. And then you can run the sketch and it will be displayed on your mobile screen. And also an app icon will be created on your screen. And then you can use it as an app. So this can be used as an app. So processing.video does not exist either. Okay.
Sir, D and D, F and D.
Can you comment me? Hello. So you have to go to import library, add library, and I hope video is installed. If it is not installed, only you'll be getting the error. So the video has a library has to be installed. So has anyone got the output by any chance? I'd be happy to hear. Participants, have you got the output or can I move to the next program? Which if you don't have the hero marker, then I can move to the next program so that it will be beneficial for you.
So that file to be opened in which software to print it?
This you have to open in processing. I hope you attended yesterday's session.
Yeah.
The same software you have to open.
Okay, that is fine. Like not sir, pad.hero file.
No. That you need not execute.
To print it. To show it.
That thing. So there will be something called as hero.png. That
okay,
one.
That file. Okay, fine.
So I hope no one has any doubts. I'll move on to the next thing. And before that, I like to show something interesting. So this augmented reality thing can be controlled via potentiometers. That is why yesterday I said if you have potentiometer, 10K potentiometers, it will be good. So this augmented reality potentiometer control 3-axis robotic arm. So you need to uncomment some lines in the program which I have sent you, and then you can actually work with this potentiometers, and you can control the robo. Similarly, there's something called as a lizard, which is available in my book. So that can also be controlled using this potentiometer based control mechanism. So that you can, if you show the hero marker, then the lizard will appear, and you can try changing the potentiometer values, and it will move forward and backward. So now we'll move on to the second hands-on session. So this is on tracking an object. So if an object is available in the field of view of the camera, then it can be tracked. So that tracking, how to track it, I'll be showing it right now. And I hope you have the processing installed, and you need not have to worry to You not worry about any other things like a hero marker. This just needs a different color object in your hand, like which is different from the background. So I hope you are with me and you have the screen open. Hello. Are you able to hear me? Can anyone respond? Are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Okay. And then go to desktop, IoT underscore robotics, CV underscore graph of trajectory. That is computer vision graph of trajectory. So you open that. And then you have to open CV underscore graph of trajectory.pde. So what happens here is, I'll explain the program first and then we'll see the output. So what happens here is processing.serial. It is used for serial communication if you have a camera, external camera connected to this, and input processing.video. So the processing.video usually comes installed with the software. And the capture video. So what you're going to capture is something called as a video. And then you're going to track something, that is track color, that is being defined, and the threshold value is set to 25. And now what we are going to do is, we are going to see what is instead void setup. And the screen of this size will open up, and the smooth transition is enabled, and the frame rate is set to 30. Then the string capture list is enabled, so that list of cameras are actually shown. Then the video is video equal to new capture this camera. So the camera number zero will be actually started. That is, everything starts with zero. If you have connected a second camera to your laptop, you can need to put it as one. Then video dot start. Then track color. Color something if yellow in color. This is 255.255.0. If something is pure yellow in color, it will start tracking. But that case is very difficult to see. And void capture event. So capture the video. So we have to capture the video, and the video dot read is enabled. So in void draw, we are going to track video with a delay of 0 milliseconds. And once the track video function is called, it goes inside the track video, and the video loads pixels, and it is converted into the image. And the threshold is set, and the average X value, Y value, and the count values are set. So now two loops have started, one for the width and one for the height. So the location is chosen, like the location of the object, at X and Y, and the current color of the pixel is noted down once you click it. So what happens is, current pixel, current pixels red, green, and blue colors are currently noted in R1, G1, B1, and red, green, and blue are noted in R2, G2, and B2. That is for the next frame. So the distance between these two pixels are calculated, and if it is less than the square of the threshold, then it will be weightage will be given, and the point XY will be plotted. So what happens here is we have to click the mouse. I'll show how we are clicking the mouse. This SQ, when this is called, it goes inside this float, and the distance value is calculated. And it is utilized over here. So this part of the program where the count is more than zero, this part will actually draw a circle at the tracked pixel. So that is what it is used for. Now I'll run the program. If I run the program, you will get something like this on the screen. On the left hand side, you will see your video. So I'm going to just show you an object. Say something blue, and just click on the object blue. So once you click on it, what happens is it starts tracing the trajectory. If I bring it down, you'll be able to see it going down. I hope all the participants are able to get the output. So if I move, as I'm moving it, it moves. So again, the same thing goes over here. If any participant is able to do this and get the output, please send me a screenshot of it. The first two participants will get a free book. You can send it to the email ID, which I had shown earlier. I'll post it in the drop box, the comment box again. This is my email ID. You can send a screenshot to this email ID. The first two participants will get a free copy of a book related to robotics. So if you have any doubts regarding this, if I have to repeat something, you can ask me now. There are totally about 100 participants, and I expect at least 10 questions. Participants, do be awake and post your questions. So if the participants have any doubts, you can post it in the chat box. You can also unmute yourself and you can ask your questions.
Sir, output is mailed to you.
Yeah, okay, I'll check it. So if you want to learn more about this kind of computer controlled robots, I have written a book called Build Your Own Computer Controlled Robots from Scratch. It's available on Amazon, both Kindle version and the paperback version. You can actually go through that book and you can make more projects on your own. So ma'am, can we end the session? I think participants are not asking any doubts. Hello. So as of now, the Python code is not supported to the best of my knowledge in processing. So you have to go with JavaScript. And once reading the video, yeah, there is a tutorial on coding train, Aruna. Actually, it teaches you how to start recording the video, and you can also save it once it is completed. So I might send you the link after the session is over. The step-by-step tutorial can be found in my book, actually. So I have written everything clearly. So this is like Build Your Own Computer Controlled Robots from Scratch. So everything is written step-by-step in the book so that you can connect it to the Arduino. The code for the Arduino is also given in the book. And you can actually download them and you can work with it. Yeah, beginners, if they refer to the book, they'll be able to develop robo applications. Actually, you just need to know a little background about theoretical background about processing software, and then if you start reading the book, you will be able to create your own robots. There are actually six to seven projects in the book, and if you do it step by step, you will be able to do it. Not only the robots which I have shown today can be made. There are lots and lots of projects which can be made. If you have made your own robo, and if you want to control the forward, backward motion, and you can control it using this processing IDE, integrated development environment. Some participant had said that he has sent an email. I actually didn't get the email. So if you have sent it, please verify whether it is the same address I have posted in the chat. Yeah, for processing, there is a website called processing.org. So you can go to that website called processing.org and you can get some references about creating artistic views like patterns on the screen, a screensaver or something like that.
Yes, sir. Send to the same mail ID.
So there is a library available in processing help. So you can go to help and you can go to reference. Here the reference, if you see, like every function is being shown. I hope you are able to see it. So suppose if you want to draw something like a ellipse, you just need to click on the ellipse and it will say how to create an ellipse. So we'll try changing the circle to ellipse in this program. Like, so okay, it was an ellipse already. So we can actually change the size of this, and you can see. Maybe we'll try changing it to some other shape called a rectangle. to show the object here. And now it is a rectangle. Before it was a circle. Now it's a square basically because we have given both the shapes to be same. So this is how you can learn every JavaScript functions. So if you have any doubts, you can ask. So has anyone got output like changing the ellipse to a rectangle? Okay, fine. I'll ask some questions if everyone is silent. I don't want it to be silent. Yesterday's session, we saw something like creating a virtual robotic arm. So in that robotic arm, I said that it rotates for 360 degrees. That is for full 360 degrees. Can anyone read out the line in the program where you have to change if I want to rotate only to 0 to 90 degree? I repeat the question. In yesterday's session, the creating the robotic arm, the slider's position was, I said in the slider position, if you can change it from 0 to 180, it will rotate for 180. By default, it rotates for 360 degrees. So if you can just post a comment in the chat box, which line exactly has to be changed so that you have to change the value from 0 to 90. And if you can post it, then you will get a free book. Let's see who does it first. The first two participants will be getting it. I hope you got my question. If I want to repeat, then I can do it. I'll repeat the question. In yesterday's robotic arm tutorial, for changing the rotation of the base from full degree rotation, that is 0 to 360 and 360 back to zero, I had said that if you rotate, change some values, it will rotate from 0 to 90 degree. So can you tell me which line it is and change the values from 0 to 90 degree so that it rotates for 0 to 90 degrees, and then post it in the comment. Only that line of the program, only one line in the program. Yeah, I'm waiting for you people to reply to the question which I asked. I'll repeat the question again. In yesterday's session, we changed the value from 0 to 360 to 0 to 180. If you remember that, and if you have done it, I think you will be able to answer this question. So if I want to rotate from 0 to 90 alone, so what value you will change, and can you send me the line in the program where it has to be changed after changing the numbers? Please send the line in the program. Copy paste the line in the comment after changing it from 0 to 90. Okay, fine, I'll give you the answer. The answer is, dot set range 0 to 180 that has to be changed from 0 to 90. I think I can give it to the person who has answered set range, because they came close to that. Yeah, you are right. The Ramya, the participant, has answered it correctly. I request the participant Ramya to send an email to this email ID, that is my email ID, so that you can get the free book. So, ma'am, can we end the session? Hello, organizers. Can we end the session?
Yes, sir. Sure.
Okay. So I thank everyone for attending this session, two sessions, one yesterday and today. My email ID is again vsrajashekhar@gmail.com. You can mail me at any time if you have doubts in any of the projects which you do, or if your student is doing some project and if you need any help, you can feel free to email me at this email address. I'll be happy to answer your queries. I repeat, my email ID is vsrajashekhar@gmail.com. I thank everyone for attending the session. Have a nice day.
And we also thank you, sir, for accepting our request and joining with our STTP. Thank you so much, sir, for your valuable 2-day session. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Dear participants, tomorrow all of you need to join by 10 o'clock. Tomorrow whole day attendance is much more important than any other day. And 20 MCQs will be given along with the feedback form, two different Google forms. So that out of 20 MCQs, minimum 50%, 10 MCQs should be right enough. Only then the certificate will be issued. Suppose if there is a discrepancy in your attendance, tomorrow if you attend to the fullest feedback form and assessment and attending, definitely you will be given attendance. Minimum 70% we are considering. If at all some lagging is there, let us see your tomorrow's participation. Based on that, it will be issued. So let us join all by 10 o'clock tomorrow and afternoon by 2 o'clock. Subsequently, the Google form will be issued, MCQ, and for the feedback form. So we'll be giving sufficient time. Minimum 1 hour we'll be giving. So within that, you may need to participate and answer to the questions. With that note, wish you all happy evening. Have a nice day. Thank you all. Let us meet again tomorrow by 10 o'clock.